Good afternoon. Passengers say they thought they were going to die when a LATAM Airlines flight from Sydney to Auckland experienced a violent mid-air drop. This afternoon, we're hearing harrowing first-hand accounts from travellers on board.
It was like a scene out of a movie. I had dozed off and luckily had my seatbelt engaged, and I opened my eyes and there was various individuals at the top of the plane, just stuck to the roof, and then they fell to the floor. People were screaming and crying. It was mass chaos. And then I just kind of resigned to the fact that this could be it. It was like a scene out of The Exorcist.
I just saw everyone flying, hitting the ceiling and then moving down. We spent the next 40 minutes thinking, are we gonna land? Are we gonna fall? Are we gonna leave? Are we gonna die?
It happened in a split second, and then suddenly all the devices and bags were up near the roof, and then next moment everything was scattered on the ground, screaming, crying, and lots of injuries. I'm not really religious, but I certainly prayed that I made it home safe.
Joining me live from the newsroom is Chief Reporter Chris Reason. Chris, what are we hearing about the cause of this sudden plunge?
Good afternoon, Anne. Well, LATAM Airlines appears to have ruled out weather or clear air turbulence, saying it was a technical fault, while the pilot himself has gone much further, telling one passenger he completely lost control of the aircraft and the gauges went blank. The eight-year-old Boeing 787 Dreamliner was flying from Sydney to Auckland, bound for Santiago, when it suddenly dropped hundreds of feet in the space of a second or two. One passenger described it as being like at the apex of a roller coaster and then plunging down the other side. Any passengers and possessions that weren't locked down were sent airborne into the ceiling and overhead baggage bins, some even breaking the panelling. LATAM Flight 800 was carrying 263 passengers and 9 cabin crew. Some seriously thought they were about to lose their lives. In total, 50 were injured, 10 hospitalised. It's the latest in a series of incidents for Boeing. In January, we saw that door that blew off the Alaskan Airlines 737. And last week, a wheel fell off a United Airlines Boeing 777 in San Francisco. As news broke today out of the US that Boeing had failed 33 of 89 audits in a safety investigation this year. Now, a replacement aircraft was sent today to Auckland to pick up yesterday's passengers, with New Zealand's air investigators announcing they're seizing the cockpit voice and flight data recorders for an inquiry to be run by the Chilean Civil Aviation Authority. Anne?
Chief Reporter Chris Reason. Thank you, Chris. One passenger claims the pilot admitted he had basically lost the ability to fly the plane when his instruments failed. For more on this, Keith Tonkin joins us, the Managing Director of Aviation Projects. Keith, good afternoon to you. Clearly a terrifying experience for the passengers and crew. What's likely to have caused the sudden drop?
Good afternoon, Anne. Well, we're not really sure. Because of the pilot's advice about the loss of the instrumentation, we're not really certain that it's an external factor like turbulence that you might expect would cause this sort of situation. And it's more likely to be something to do with the onboard systems and flight controls and the instrumentation that provides that information to the pilots when they're flying the aircraft.
Well, the plane was a Boeing 787-9 Dreamliner. What's the record for this plane?
Yeah, the aircraft's been flying for some years now, and it has a very good safety record. And this is a one-off as far as I understand, but it would be very disconcerting for the pilot sitting up the front of that aircraft, losing the instrumentation and losing control of that aircraft for a brief moment.
Well, as we said, we've heard that he lost the instrument panel. It blacked out, apparently. Is this plausible? What would the pilot have done at this point?
It is plausible, although there are lots of redundancies in those systems, and it's relatively inexplicable to me to understand how that could have occurred. And we don't know why, as a result of that blanking of the instruments, the aircraft then suffered that loss of altitude at the same time.
Well, it hasn't been a good run for Boeing. They've had recent trouble with the 737 MAX. Will there be another inquiry?
Oh, I think there'll be an investigation into the situation, because the Boeing manufacturer of the aircraft and the operator and the regulators will be very interested to understand why it's happened, to find out what caused it, what the results of those problems were, and how to solve them for any future aircraft operations.
So for passengers, the lesson here is to keep your seatbelt on, but should we be worried about hopping on these planes?
Definitely the lesson is to keep your seatbelt comfortably fastened while you're flying in an aircraft, regardless of this situation. And we don't expect that this is a systemic problem. It'll be very interesting to find out what the investigation reveals to make sure that we understand it and that it can be resolved for future aircraft operations.
Keith Tonkin from Aviation Projects, thank you for your time and insight this afternoon.
Welcome.